Sir Arthur Ignatius Conan Doyle, Order of St. John, Deputy Lieutenant, born 22 May 1859, died 7th July 1930, was an English writer best known for his detective fiction featuring the character Sherlock Holmes. Originally a physician, in 1887 he published A Study in Scarlet, the first of four novels and more than 50 short stories about Holmes and Dr. Watson. The Sherlock Holmes stories are generally considered milestones in the field of crime fiction. Doyle was a prolific writer. His non-Sherlockian works include fantasy and science fiction stories about Professor Challenger and humorous stories about the Napoleonic soldier Brigadier Gerard, as well as plays, romances, poetry, non-fiction and historical novels. One of Doyle's early short stories, J. Hogarth Jefferson's Statement, helped to popularize the mystery of the Mary Celeste. The Lost World is a science fiction novel by Doyle, published in 1912, concerning an expedition to a plateau in the Amazon basin of South America where prehistoric animals still survive. It was originally published serially in the Strand magazine and illustrated by New Zealand porn artist Terry Rowntree during the months of April to November 1912. The character of Professor Challenger was introduced in this book. The novel also describes a war between indigenous people and a vicious tribe of ape-like creatures. Bernhard Kellerman, born March 4, 1879, 4th, Kingdom of Bavaria, died October 17, 1951, was a German author and poet. Der Tunnel is a novel by Kellerman published in April 1913. The novel sold 100,000 copies in the 6 months after its publication, and it became one of the most successful books of the first half of the 20th century. By 1939, its circulation had reached millions. The main theme of the novel is social progress, particularly with respect to modern technology. Paul Karl Wilhelm Schierbart, born 8th January 1863 in Danzig, died 15th October 1915 in Berlin, was a German author of fantastic literature and drawings. He was also published under the pseudonym Kuno Küfer and is best known for the book Glasarchitektur, 1914. Schierbart was associated with Expressionist architecture and one of its leading proponents, Bruno Tott. He composed aphoristic poems about glass for the Tott's Glass Pavilion at the Werpend Exhibition, 1914. His Lesebendio, Ein Asteroidenroman, Lesebendio, an asteroid novel published in 1913, is a utopian work concerning the alien inhabitants of an asteroid in a distant solar system, and one alien's attempt to link their asteroid to other parts of their system. George Allen England, born 9th February 1877, died 26th June 1936, was an American writer and explorer, best known for his speculative and science fiction. He attended Harvard University and later in life unsuccessfully ran for governor of Maine. England was a socialist and many of his works have socialist themes. England's trilogy, Darkness and Dawn, published in 1912, 1913 and 1914 as The Vacant World, Beyond the Great Oblivion and Afterglow, tells the story of two modern people who awake 1,000 years after the Earth was devastated by a meteor. They work to rebuild civilization. Richard A. Lupoff has noted that Darkness and Dawn contains an unfortunate element of racism. The villains who menace the heroes are descended from African Americans. Herland is a utopian novel from 1915, written by Charlotte Perkins Gilman, feminist, humanist, novelist, writer of short stories, poetry, and non-fiction, and a lecturer for social reform. The book describes an isolated society composed entirely of women, who reproduce via parthenogenesis, asexual reproduction. The result is an ideal social order, free of war, conflict, and domination. It was first published in monthly installments as a serial in 1915 in The Forerunner, a magazine edited and written by Gilman between 1909 and 1916, with its sequel, With Her in Ireland, beginning immediately thereafter in the January 1916 issue. The book is often considered to be the middle volume in her utopian trilogy, preceded by Moving the Mountain, 1911, and followed by With Her in Ireland, 1916. It was not published in book form until 1979. Guy Thorne was the pen name of Cyril Arthur Edward Ranger Gull, born 1875, died 9th January 1923, a prolific English journalist and novelist best known for his novel When It Was Dark, The Story of a Great Conspiracy, 1903. He also wrote under the names C. Ranger Gull and Leonard Cresswell Inglibby. He predicted armor tanks in his 1915 model, the Cruiser on Wheels. Gustav Mehring, born January 19, 1868, died December 4, 1932, was the pseudonym of Gustav Meyer, an Austrian author, novelist, dramatist, translator, and banker, most famous for his novel The Golem. He has been described as the most respected German-language writer in the field of supernatural fiction. The Green Face, 1916, is Mehring's post-apocalyptic near-future take on The Wandering Jew. Homunculus is a six-chapter German science fiction film directed by Otto Rippert. It was released in 1916 starring Olaf Fons as the Homunculus, Ernst Ludwig as Professor Ortmann, Albert Pohl as Dr. Hansen, Lore Ruckert as Dr. Marguerite Hansen, Max Rubeck as General Procurator Steffens, Leah Bohr as Dr. De General Procurator Steffens, Friedrich Kuhn as Edgar Roden, Theodore Luz as Sven Friedland, Mechthild is Fine as Margot, and Oddegg Edmisson. Otto Witt, born 1875, died 1923, was a Swedish author. He was one of the prominent figures in early Swedish science fiction. He did, among other things, publish Hugin, a science magazine which was filled with speculative articles and fiction. Hugin was one of the first magazines to regularly carry science fiction in the world, although it appears to have had little influence outside Sweden. Victor Rousseau Emmanuel, originally born as A. Victor Rousseau Emmanuel, was born 2 January 1879 in England to Joel Emmanuel and Georgiana Rousseau. He died 6 April 1960 in Tarryton, New York. Primarily a writer of pulp fiction, he was active in Great Britain and the United States during the first half of the 20th century. Regarding the first two decades of his career, he wrote predominantly under the pen names Victor Rousseau, H.M. Egbert, and V.R. Emmanuel, but, come the 1930s, officially abandoned these and numerous others in favor of establishing Victor Rousseau as a recognizable name in the pulp fiction field. Written in the spring of 1914, Emmanuel's magnum opus, The Messiah of the Cylinder, was an answering cry against H.G. Wells, When the Sleeper Wakes. Despite acceptance by Everybody's magazine, the story lingered for 3 years, until finally serialized in 4 installments, 1917 June, July, August, September. Himmelskibet, Excelsior / A Trip to Mars / Das Himmelsif is a 1918 Danish film about a trip to Mars. In 2006, the film was restored and re-released on DVD, by the Danish Film Institute. Phil Hardy says it is the film that marked the beginning of the space opera subgenre of science fiction, but notes that Denmark did not make another science fiction film until Reptilicus in 1962. The Moon Pool is a fantasy novel by American writer Abraham Merritt. It originally appeared as 2 short stories in All Story Weekly. The Moon Pool, 1918, and its sequel, Conquest of the Moon Pool, 1919. These were then reworked into a novel released in 1919. The protagonist, Dr. Goodwin, would later appear in Merritt's second novel The Metal Monster, 1920. Although Merritt did not invent the Lost World novel, he followed in the footsteps of Bulwer Lytton, Burroughs, Conan Doyle, and others. This work extended the tradition. All Round is a 1918 Hungarian science fiction horror film directed by Michael Curtiz and Edmund Fritz and starring Gyula Erdölgy. Little is known about this film, which is now believed to be lost. It is a variation on the original legend of All Round, in which a mad scientist creates a beautiful but demonic child from the forced union between a woman and a man recruit. All Round, by Henker Stokter, Dean and Dyrote Han. All Round, the Hangman's Daughter, named Red Hannah, is a 1918 silent science fiction horror film directed by Eugen Iles and Joseph Klein and starring Max Ozinger. Despite the title, this film has very little connection to the novel by Hans-Heinz Ewers, with the only reference being to the man recruit, which plays a role in saving the dying child. This film was released in the US under the title Sacrifice, and in contrast to the Hungarian film by the same name, an intact version can still be found at George Eastman House. The film was produced by Luna Film and distributed by Natural Film Gesellschaft mit beschränkter Haftung. The art direction was by Arthur Gunther. William Hope Hodgson, born 15 November 1877, died 19 April 1918, was an English author. He produced a large body of work, consisting of essays, short fiction, and novels, spanning several overlapping genres including horror, fantastic fiction, and science fiction. Hodgson used his experiences at sea to lend authentic detail to his short horror stories, many of which are set on the ocean, including his series of linked tales forming the Sargasso Sea Stories. His novels, such as The House on the Borderland, 1908, and The Nightland, 1912, feature more cosmic themes, but several of his novels also focus on horrors associated with the sea. Early in his writing career, Hodgson dedicated effort to poetry, although few of his poems were published during his lifetime. He also attracted some notice as a photographer and achieved renown as a bodybuilder. He died in World War I at age 40. Hodgson joined the University of London's Officers Training Corps, refusing to have anything to do with the sea despite his experience and third mate's certificate. He received a commission as a lieutenant in the Royal Artillery. In 1916, he was thrown from a horse and suffered a broken jaw and a serious head injury. He received a mandatory discharge and returned to writing. Refusing to remain on the sidelines, Hodgson recovered sufficiently to re-enlist. His published articles and stories from the time reflect his experience in war. He was killed by the direct impact of an artillery shell at the 4th Battle of Ypres in April 1918, sources suggest either the 17th or 19th. He was eulogized in the Times on 2nd May 1918. The American magazine Adventure, to which Hodgson had contributed fiction, also ran an obituary which reprinted a clipping from his widow, describing how Hodgson led a group of NCOs to safety under heavy fire. We've gone from lost worlds to unseeable futures. In the next episode, we'll meet a man who not only saw the future, he placed a truckload of bullseyes on it. See you then.